Hello friends and welcome to Tutorials Point. In this segment of the video, I'm going to show you how date slicer work in Power BI. So guys, you all must be knowing that the date element is the most important element at the time of business analysis. The reason being, it helps me to do a future forecast in such a way that how I'm going to generate revenue in the upcoming years. And with the same element, I can do the previous forecast as well so that I can understand what I have been performing so far. Alright guys, so in Power BI Desktop, in date slicer, we have four type of date slicer. If I move on to the next slide, you can see there are four types of date slicer. The first being is the between, before, after and list. Now what are these four different kind of slicer? We'll be having a better understanding of this in our practical approach.
Hello friends and welcome. In this video, we are going to see how to use date slicer in Power BI. In our previous video, we have already seen how to use normal slicer and get the result accordingly. This time we'll be just focusing on the date part and how to create date slicer in Power BI. So let's get started off. I will go under the visualization pane and simply select this slicer visualization. I get a blank slicer out here. I will simply take this date section and drop it here. The moment I drop it here, do you see there is a timeline that has been created starting from 1st of January 1999 and ending at 31st December 2015. That would be my last entry in this particular database. Alright, so this is what it is showing you the report for. Now it is giving me an option where I can select a date range from which I want to see the revenue. Alright. Now if I go under this 1st of January 1999, do you see there is a box? If you simply select this box or click on this block, it will automatically give you a drop down menu of calendar from where I can either select which year I'd like to mention and what is the date. So let's say 10th of January 2002 to I would like to get the report for 17th of December 2015. All right, so this is giving me the report accordingly. I can either use this drop down menu or also I can use the slider with the help of which I can actually change the date. Would like to see guys? So if I select this circle and if I drag it, you can see the end date is automatically changing. We have the start date, we have the end date. If I want to change the start date, I have to simply go on this particular circle and drag it. So accordingly, it is modifying the report and getting me the results accordingly. So this is what a between range looks like, and this is nothing but my timeline. All right, now let's go ahead and see what are the different options that I see out here. So if I click on this drop down menu, I can see as of now we are starting off with the between range. Right, now let's start with the before. What does this before do? So if I simply select this, you can see the start date is automatically grayed out. That means I would like to get the report before the end date, so I can mention the end date what it should be and it fetches me the results accordingly. And similarly, my projection changes. Do you see there is a slight change in the donut chart, but you can see a significant change in the tree map itself. Alright guys, so this is what particularly this portion is changing a lot. So this is how you can use the before drop down menu. And if I select after, now see what happens if I select after. My end date is become stagnant. That means I cannot change my end date, but I can change my start date, right? So this is how the before, after and between is working. Alright, so if I also go ahead and click on this drop down menu, I can see there are so many other options. List and drop down, we have already seen before how it works and how it gives me the results. Now let's go ahead and see how the relative drop down menu is working. Alright, so if I click on this relative option, you can see it is helping me to fetch a report relative to what. Now as you can see, there is the text out here is very small, so let's quickly go ahead and change the text. I need to go to the format button, and under the format button I have numeric inputs. In that I simply have to increase this last. Alright, so let's go ahead and make it this as 13. Looks good. Alright, now what it is showing you, it is showing you the relative report. Let's say I want to get the report of last 3. Now it is giving you an option. Now what are the options that we have? It can give me last 3 days, 3 weeks calendar, months calendar, years and years calendar. So let's say I would like to get the report for the last 3 years. All right. So the moment I select last 3 years, it is telling me it is starting from 24th of April and ending on 23rd of April. That is the last 3 years. Now you see, if you see, it is 2015 and it is 2018. So automatically it is giving me a particular date range, right? From this particular drop-down menu, I can select any category or any criteria which I wish to apply. So this is as simple as to use the relative drop down menu. All right, now I will again go here and see what are the different things or different options. So if I select list, it is giving me list of all the date range, which does not look nice. It's better to have a drop down menu. As we can see now, it is occupying much less of a space, and if I click on this drop down menu, I can actually select the particular year or the particular date which I would like to get the report for. Isn't that easy, guys? So this was one thing about it. Also, I would like to get you, I would like to show you one more thing in this, is that I will create one more slicer out here. I'll create one more slicer, a blank slicer, okay? And in this particular slicer, I'll drop the years. Now, see what happens when I drop the years. So, automatically, I'm getting the list of all the years, and I can select a particular year and get the results accordingly. Alright, now this is what we can do in the normal slicer out here as well. But what I would like to share you specifically, let's say that I have a date range, right? Under the format tab, if I go to this general drop down menu, do you see there is an orientation? If you click on this drop down menu, I have two orientation, that is vertical, which can be seen right now. Now the moment I select horizontal, see what happens. The moment I select horizontal, I can get a timeline according to different years. So let's say that I would like to have the report for the year 2000. It will show me the report for 2000 and 2003. So it gets me the report of, if I want to select multiple items, as we have already learned, we have to use the control key and select the multiple items, and it is giving me the results accordingly, guys. Isn't that easy and great? So in such a way that if I select this horizontal menu, it is giving me an option in like a button, right? Simply with a single click of a button, I can get my dashboard, that is the region which we are working on. I can quickly customize my dashboard with the help of just a single click. So this is how the slicer, or if I like to specify, this is how the date slicer works in Power BI. All right, guys, so this was all for this video. See you until next time.